there, my lovelies. This is Jana here. Welcome back. So today we're going to make something that is widely requested on this channel, which is salami or mortadella or bologna. Something, it's a hybrid. And we're going to use simple ingredients, I promise you. You're not going to have to climb a mountain on the first day of autumn and pick up that rare flower to make it like you see all over the internet. No, simple ingredients. First, we're going to need cooked red lentils and cooked rice. And along with that, we're going to add salt, MSG, smoked paprika, cumin, garlic powder and onion powder, and white or black pepper. Add agave syrup, liquid smoke. If you don't have liquid smoke, you can add smoked paprika. Some oil to make it extra moist. Some beetroot juice just for the color, and blend well. This recipe was sent to me by Nina Vecchi, something similar. She sent the recipe and using raw uncooked lentil powder, which to me, the taste was amazing, but to me it was a little bit too grainy, you know, so I wanted it soft. So that's why I decided to cook the lentils. However, if you cook the lentils, you have to drain the water very well, because otherwise it's going to be too difficult to firm it up later, you see? Also, what I have also added to this recipe, which is totally optional, is the psyllium husks. I added it because I wanted it extra malleable, you know, as in you can fold it if you want, so it looks extra pretty. But if you don't have it, by any means, you don't have to add it. But if you are going to add it, it's time to rehydrate it now in water. And while blending it, you add the psyllium husks little by little, okay, so it gets easier for your food processor to process everything. Otherwise, it's going to be like this huge block. And if you don't have a very good food processor, just like me, so it's going to be a little bit difficult. Add tomato passata or tomato puree with a little bit of water or just tomato sauce. Add a little bit of oregano if you want. If you don't like lentils, because it has a little bit of a lentil taste, so if you don't like lentils, you can use pressed tofu or you can use cooked chickpeas. It's brilliant with cooked chickpeas. I have made it before with cooked chickpeas. The color gets prettier, in my opinion, because it's really similar to bologna, you know, because it's pink and light pink. But so it's like a matter of preference, I think. And also you can add, instead of the lentils and the chickpea or the tofu, you can add sauteed mushrooms. Brilliant also, but then it's a little bit more smoky. It reminds a little bit more of a ham, you know, instead of a bologna. But this is a hybrid, so who cares? Use whatever you prefer. Now, it's time to dissolve it, the agar-agar in soy milk. You're going to dissolve 3 tablespoons in a little bit of soy milk. Don't worry about taking notes on the quantities right now. It's going to be linked down below the full recipe and on my website. So just listen to the recipe. And you're going to have to boil it for 3 to 5 minutes, careful not to burn, because the agar-agar, it needs high temperatures to get activated. And now you can add everything into a large pot, and then you add the agar-agar, and along with that, the cornstarch or tapioca starch. I actually forgot to add it while I was blending, but if you are going to add the tapioca starch while you are blending it in your food processor, add and then process it just enough so it gets mixed into the mixture. Because if you process it like from the beginning, it's going to deactivate the starch in the tapioca starch or in the cornstarch, and then it's not gonna work for nothing. It's just like, it's not going to firm it up. So pay attention to that. Now you're going to need some elbow grease here, because you're going to be stirring it for 15 minutes. And it's going to form this film on the bottom of your pot. Do not worry, it comes out right off. You just put some water in it, and then it's gonna lift. It's going to get released super easy, and then you can put it in your dishwasher, so you don't need to worry about that. After that, you add this into a mold, any kind of mold of your preference. So I wanted this time to make it round, because the other times, which I didn't film by the way, I made it square, but I wanted round. So I used an old water bottle, So I cut it and yeah, so it was perfect. Let it cool down, put it in your fridge for at least 6 hours before you enjoy it. Isn't it? Because I just gave you a whole range of substitutions to which is going to be very well explained in the recipe on my website and down below as well. So you don't need to worry about, oh my God, it's not gonna... It is. And you make it and then you can freeze it. And I like to freeze it in a whole block because every time you slice the cheese and then you freeze it, or if you ground the cheese or these to freeze it, you're going to lose a lot of the moist, you know. That's why I don't like buying already grounded cheese, because a lot of the moist is already gone. So this is it for today. I hope you make it, and if you do, please tag me. You can add in here, like I have done before, olives and red pepper. It gets super pretty. I didn't have any laying around in my kitchen, and I really wanted to use whatever I had in hand, and the taste is amazing. It grows in you, you know, like the good simple foods that they're like the Carpenter songs that you're like, oh, okay, the Carpenters, but the more you listen to, the more it grows in you. So this is my Carpenter's food, if you can say that. I love them, by the way. So again, I hope you make it, and tag me on my Facebook and Instagram. And apart from that, I just love you. Thank you for being here with me, and I see you next time. And until then, bye. I forgot to try it on camera, but I'll do now.